COP26 has just concluded, and I think it's fair to say that the results are not very tangible. According to an estimate by a climate action tracker, the pledges which we've had from the various governments between now and 2030 would still be consistent with global warming of 2.4 degrees by the end of the century, so definitely beyond the range which had been agreed at, in Paris in 2015. However, I think it would be wrong to discard any impact of the fight against climate change right now on our economies. It's becoming very tangible, actually. One, because you can see the volatility on energy prices over the last few months. To some extent, it is actually a result of the belief in this industry that you have to control the amount of output that you can still offer to the world, given the possibility that in 20, 30, 40 years from now, they won't be able to produce anymore. But maybe the more positive tangible impact is what's going to happen with investment. Indeed, to fight climate change, we will need to renew a good chunk of our capital base. And according to Princeton University, or to estimates by the European Commission, or by the Chinese authorities, in these three regions, the US, Europe, and China, there will be a need for an additional investment effort of between 1 and 3% of GDP every year between now and 2030 for us to give us a chance, actually, to limit global warming. When we talk about the cost of fighting climate change, it's always actually a bit misleading. It's not really a cost if what you need to do is to invest. By investing, you're going to spur growth, you're going to increase GDP, and this is already happening in a number of countries. To give you one concrete example, last year, the European Commission has launched its Next Generation Pact. This Next Generation Pact is going to be partly dedicated to funding investment projects towards decarbonization. In France, Germany, Italy, on average, this will increase public investment by between 1 and 6% of GDP every year between now and 2026. So for now, we can already see that this is going to play a major role in spurring growth in the Eurozone in the next few years. So for now, I would say that the fight against climate change is probably playing a positive role on growth, especially in the regions which are early in this process of investing towards decarbonated industries and technology. However, we must not be naive. There will be a cost. You can see this already, for instance, in the cost of carbon on the EU's carbon trading platform. We moved to a price which was below 20 euros per tonne to a price above 60 euros per tonne. This will probably continue to increase, and probably more importantly for our economies, the carbon trading system is going to be extended to a wider array of economic sectors. So this will probably have an impact on profit margins, not just right now, but in the next few years. The other potential cost to the economy may come from border tax. It's going to be very, very tempting in developed nations to try to nudge emerging and developing nations to go faster into their own decarbonization process by basically imposing a tax on products produced in the south with a big carbon content exported towards Europe or towards the US. This will obviously increase the cost of these imports. This will be detrimental to a purchasing power. It's not for now, it's not for immediate consumption, it's probably beyond our forecasting horizon for now. But think of it, you know, in the next 3, 4, 5 years, this will probably start being a detrimental impact on purchasing power. For now, the impact of the fight against climate change is probably a positive for GDP growth, especially in the regions which are well advanced in this fight. Later on, in 5 to 10 years, it will probably become a net negative because of the impact of carbon tax and border tax. However, I would say there is just no alternative. Even if there is a cost to fighting climate change, the alternative, which is doing nothing, would be much worse in terms of welfare loss, in terms of impact on GDP. Just to leave you with one figure, according to the Burke, Siang and Miguel estimate, which is increasingly used as a benchmark. If we don't do anything to curb climate change, by the end of the century, the impact on GDP per head at the global level could be minus 23%. In other words, even the most pessimistic estimate of the cost of fighting climate change is actually lower than the most optimistic estimate of just letting things slide and doing nothing about climate change. So yes, there will probably be some pain, but it's well worth it.